perfection. Panther perfection. State championship. Sure has a nice ring to it. It has a familiar ring to it. The sixth state championship for Permian High School football. We look back to past champions, 1965, 1972, 1980, 84, 89, and now 1991. Each of those teams has a special place in Permian football history. Each is special to the fans and, of course, the players that make up each of those squads. But the 1991 team, I think, stands alone. It was the 1991 team that got the job done with a gun pointed to their head. The 1991 team played inspired football, inspired by the events of the year before. The 1991 Permian football team put mojo back on top in Texas high school football. This is the story of the Permian football team, the 1991 Class 5A state champions, the team that ended the year dancing on the field at Texas Stadium. The 1991 season started September 6th in El Paso. On the first play of the new year, El Paso Irvine went 80 yards, Permian Trail 6-0. But the rest of the game was all mojo. The Rockets picking up just 46 yards on the remaining 41 plays. At the half, Permian was in control 38-6 on their way to a 59-6 opening season victory. Game two of the season was sweet revenge for Permian. Tyler John Tyler came to town, one of only two teams to beat the Panthers the year before. Quarterback Stormy Case threw for 221 yards and three touchdowns, two to Tony Daniels, one to Will Wagner. The Mojo defense was strong once again, holding the Tyler Lions to just 164 yards. Win number two, 35-6. Timmy Ross had his best rushing night of the season in Game 3, 109 yards, including a 50-yard touchdown run, leading the Panthers past the Amarillo Golden Sandies. At the half, Permian held a 14-3 advantage. The defense rose up to the challenge in the second half. The offense had touchdowns from Malcolm Hamilton, Alan Strambler, and Bubba Jones. Mojo was 3-0 heading to the district opener. The final, 35-3 over Amarillo. The cry of "this could be the year" was heard from the west side of Odessa for this annual inner-city rivalry. But Permian made sure in the first play of the Odessa High game, this was not the year.
Hamilton at midfield. Hamilton makes one cut inside the 40. Hamilton is going to take it into the end zone. And that's a Mojo touchdown.
Shortly after Hamilton made it 7-0, Ross doubled the score after a Bronco fumble.
Stormy Case gets the ball and gives it back to Timmy Ross as blockers in front of him, has an end zone in front of him, and that's a Mojo touchdown. Timmy Ross takes it in for 6 more.
And the defense. Oh, that Mojo defense. Their first shutout of the season. While Hamilton led the way on the ground with 179 yards, we got our first look at sophomore sensation John Williams, picking up 92 yards on just 8 carries. A sneak preview into a 1,000-yard season. In the end, the unbeaten streak over the Odessa High Broncos was at 27 with a 44-0 win. A break from district play produced a showcase for the offense and the defense. 68 points against Alamogordo, New Mexico was a school record. And remember John Williams? 11 carries, 225 yards.
Sideline. Case makes a block. Williams is going to take it all the way. That's a Mojo touchdown.
There was 552 yards of offense, 422 of those on the ground. Overmatched Alamogordo held to 90 yards, 10 on the ground. Permian kicker Shane Wells scored 12 points on his own. 9 extra points set another school record. 68-0 made the Mojo mark 5-0. Back to district play the following week, and the Permian-Lee rivalry was in the spotlight.
The District 4-5A leaders are taking care of business Saturday on Super 7. The rumble and rattle, the matchup, the confrontation, the rivalry, no holds barred, hot stuff getting hotter all the time. The Rebels, Mojo, Saturday, 10:30 on Super 7.
But when the Panthers and Rebels hit the field, the only team rumbling over, around, and through the opposition was the mauling Mojo Express.
Patton puts it in the air to Robinson. He's hit. Whoa, and it's incomplete.
Will Wagner, what a hit. Lord of mercy, this does rattle your chop, friend.
Lee was held to 57 yards rushing, 70 total yards. The final, 33-0. One of the more satisfying wins of this championship season. Is it possible for a team to play an entire game and not pick up a first down? Well, it was on October 18th when Abilene fell short against the Mojo D. The Eagles had 11 yards of total offense, a record for the defense. The shutout was spoiled by a fumble return late in the game, but the 56-7 domination was starting talk that this team could be the best ever for Permian. Week 8 of the season, and Permian was starting to coast to a district title. The Midland High Bulldogs came to Ratliff Stadium. Will Wagner's 18-yard reception in the second quarter helped Permian build a 31-0 halftime advantage. The final of 38-13 put the Permian record at 8-0. November 1st, San Angelo Stadium. The battle of unbeatens in District 4-5A. Permian and San Angelo Central went into the fourth quarter tied at 7. And what a fourth quarter it was.
It's a foot race to the end zone. One man clipped it, but that's a Mojo touchdown. There's a kick by Shane Wells. Taken at the 5, fumble on the play. It's on the turf, and Permian recovers. Up the middle, and into the end zone. That's a Mojo touchdown for Malcolm Hamilton. Receivers are wide to left side for Shea Morenz. He's hit once in the backfield, gets away. Now he's going downfield for Carroll. It's completed. The Bobcats have scored. No, they're going for two on the fake. Permian smells it out. It's in the end zone. It's good. It's good for two.
Permian fans were numb when it was over, but the perfect season was still intact.
And Permian has it. Permian has it. Bubba Jones picks it up at the 31-yard line, and the Panthers will get this football game, and it looks like the bell is headed back to Mojo.
As the regular season came to a close, Permian traveled to Abilene Cooper. A 12-0 first quarter deficit was the largest margin Permian trailed by in the regular season. But don't worry, 35 unanswered points capped off the 10-0 regular season, and the Panthers were ready for the playoffs. A cold, wet day and a field more appropriate for mud wrestling started the Panthers off in the playoffs. Deficit turned into a 22-9 win. A scare, but more importantly, another victory. Round two of the playoffs, and Permian needed a blowout to get some momentum back. They got it. 56-6 over El Paso Austin.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to a rocking Rattler Stadium as we're getting ready for the
Rock!
two. Blair is hit. He's down. He's sacked.
Get on the mic and hear four. Back to back, front to front, door to door. Everybody dance to the new sound. Rock and roll, soul to soul. I'm bringing it down from the bottom to the top, from the top to the bottom.
Time clock stopped. 1:20. DeLuo in the first quarter play as John Williams is going left side. Gets a nice block down the sideline. Williams is pushed out of bounds. Case looks back to throw. Halftime, sprints to the right, looking in the end zone, and that's a Mojo touchdown! Malcolm Hamilton inside the five, and that's a no, it's not! John Williams breaks one tackle, and that's a Mojo touchdown! Second goal for the two, the pitch to Malcolm Hamilton. Needs one block, he's going to get it. Doesn't need the block, he takes it in. And that's a Mojo touchdown! That's John Williams, inside the 15, inside the 10, and that's a Mojo touchdown! There's 13 seconds left and counting down. The Permian Panthers have come back home to Ratliff Stadium after a three-week absence and have demolished El Paso Austin to advance to the third round of the Texas Class 5A playoffs.
The dream matchup of the season, number one Arlington Lamar against number two Permian, turned into a dream domination for Mojo and a nightmare for the Vikings. Hamilton has the first down as he hurdles his way inside.
Malcolm Hamilton, and that's a Bo Joe touchdown. The battle of unbeaten goes to Mojo. The Birmingham Panthers are still unbeaten, 13-0 as they head to the quarterfinals. They have ended the season for the number one Arlington Lamar Vikings.
All-American running back Sean Walters found out he hadn't faced Sam Brooks, Ephraim Areno, and Michael Comer before. When he did, he picked up 65 yards, and Permian picked up win number 13. For the third time in school history, Permian met rival Midland Lee in the state quarterfinals. Over 28,000 made the trip to Lubbock, with those in black and white enjoying what they saw a lot more than the maroon-clad fans. The rematch left no doubt of Permian's superiority.
The Permian Panthers, for the second time this year, have beaten the Lee Rebels. Still unbeaten at 14-0. The final, Permian beats Lee 35-7.
Returned to Ranlow Stadium for their semifinal matchup with a Waco team ranked third in the state. The Panthers turned it on late in the second quarter to break the game open and coast in for a 38-8 win that put Mojo back in the state championship game.
chase again, has plenty of time, looking downfield for Bergen, and that's a Mojo touchdown! Case's lined up in the backfield. There's Stormy. Down, wide open, Wagner. That's a Mojo touchdown! Fakes the pitch. Now looks to throw to Wagner in the end zone. And that's a Mojo touchdown!
What a catch!
What a grab by Will Wagner!
Folks, I want you to watch this one on the replay.
Snap back, ball down, the kick is through the upright. The pitch comes out left side to John Williams, and that's a Mojo touchdown! The kick by Shane Wells is good! Peoples looks to throw again. Sims gets it for a sack! There's 9 seconds on the clock as Stefan Molina brings his team up to the line of scrimmage. The seconds tick off. Molina kneels. And the Permian Panthers will try next week for their sixth state championship.
And so it was that the Permian Panthers advanced to the state championship game for the 11th time in school history. More and more teams throughout the state are learning firsthand what Mojo is all about. But if they still don't know, sixth grader Ramey Dean says it best in his poem called Mojo is the One. Mojo is the magic that plays day and night. Mojo is the spirit that keeps up the fight. Mojo is the caring that goes through and through. Mojo is the power that will run over you. Mojo is the offense with a drive to win. Mojo is the defense that will not give in. Mojo is the fan with a pride to yell. Mojo is the team with a victory bell. Mojo is the legend that is always first rate. Mojo is the name that's on its way to state.
If I knew back then all the things I know today, maybe I would not have changed 1 hour. Cause I learned so much from my mistakes. All the nights we cried and we prayed we'd see the morning light. We never thought that we could end.
Cam Hollingshead and the Panthers. They are 8 seconds away. One more in the books for the Permian Panthers.
Out of line. One of these days you're gonna know the scar.